Today we are going to talk about Battlefield 2 gameplays and how they will suffer a great change from now on. They are getting shorter or definitely cancelled. Welcome back to Gaming Zone. Let's start the mod topic I prepared for today. What's up everyone? Yes, I still exist, and today I would like to discuss a topic that is related to Battlefield 2 mods. Since One Man Show 4 mod, which you can check it out up there, no more gameplays or even replays came out. What happened to them and what the heck is going on? As you might know from the video where I talk about YouTube censorship, I quit the mods because I lost interest in them. And of course, I also said this. Battlefield 2 gameplays are coming back in November. Well, outside is December, and still no videos related to them. Since the start of my format revisiting, I had on plan to end these gameplays because of their length and more over long time to process them. As I returned to watch the previous gameplays, I realized why everyone actually likes them, and why so many people from there are subscribed to actually see them. Of course, nobody are watching the Gaming Zone Changes videos I upload monthly. They are basically monthly briefings and updates related to videos, the format changes, and of course what is happening to my real life issues. Right now I am in a really bad situation, the issue plaguing me being the broken monitor. Serious problem for me, which I mentioned in previous channel update. The final format of Battlefield 2 gameplay replay is ready, but these factors such as external gadgets and monitor problem maintain me from producing the videos. At the release of this video, I am working over recording from my 1080p notebook and transfer the files to the main station. It will slow down the production a little and videos will release a bit later. Thankfully this thing has decent hardware, so no worries about the quality. Now a serious discussion here. Since the modification gameplays in the older format were about half an hour long, most of the people will only watch like 5 to 10 minutes at least. Or they will just skip to the review to see the final mark and my opinion about the modification. With Gaming Zone 2.0 now fully done, I think it's time for a change, or is it? While talking with people on my Discord server, Mandy told me to keep the length of the gameplay like it was before the refresh. Others suggested to shorten the video or just review the modification instead. This is where you come to help me, friends. I've prepared 3 options for you to choose, and the most voted one will be applied in this format. Here we go. First one, keep it 30 minutes. Basically keep the same length and just introduce the new format changes and style in the video. Gameplay and review part will change for good. Second one, 15 minute video. Cutting the video length in half, but I will only play one map from the mod within 10 minutes and add the review at the final stage of the video. With this format, however, I will not have enough time to review all the maps, and some reviews might result in a slightly lower or better score. And the third one, double powered. In this variant, I have to record the Battlefield 2 mod gameplay and review separately. So in a week releases the gameplay, and in the other comes the review. It will take much more effort, and from my opinion is not really worth it. As I am a kind of a nostalgia guy, but I can't really choose from these three. That's why you will decide what is going to happen with them in the future. With Gaming Zone 2.0, I would like to introduce you to the new rating system for the custom mods featured in the gameplays. Before, my rating was based just on how the modification looked, its content, its quality, its issues and other stuff. With that mentioned, all the reviews required a proper refresh of rating. From here on I say, no more Medal of Freedom replay, just no! Here are the marks issued by me and the mod requirements to meet them. 10 out of 10. The most prestigious award ever given by Gaming Zone. Modification must be perfectly built, do not show any signs of problems, such as crashes, issues with bots or quality. The modification will get the legendary awesome badge at the end. 9 out of 10. A very well and good made mod with insignificant problems such as HUD weapon misplacements, some text issues or minor problems with bots. The modification again must be in a perfect shape in order to hit such a high rating. Awesome badge, however, will not be offered. 8 out of 10. Modifications that will get this badge will have some noticeable problems within gameplay, such as problematic bots or weird weapon balancing. To be noted, only in some maps or teams. 7 out of 10. Problems that are found more than one map, faction, vehicles and weapons. This also includes such details as balancing, models, textures, quality and other stuff. 6 out of 10. Evident problems in some departments of the mod. Those might be such as bad weapons for a faction, mediocre vehicles, weapons and other similar mentioned content before. Modification requires some improvement in future releases. 5 out of 10. Serious problems related to almost every part of the mod. At least some content must be decent enough for the modification to get this mark. Improvements are strongly recommended. 4 out of 10. Absolutely low quality made mod. Problems with content quality, issues with the maps, vehicles, weapons or factions are noticeable. Urgent intervention for developers is required. 3 out of 10. Crashing mods, bad content and weird errors and issues are reaching this mark. The mod is beyond any help at this point, might require a re-release. 2 out of 10. Complete garbage with severe problems mentioned in other marks. Battlefield 3 or similar copycats instantly get this mark if the content is ripped off from other games. And the legendary 1 out of 10. The worst mark ever issued by Gaming Zone. The mods that receive this mark are beyond playable and are just some broken mess merged into a mod for BF2. PC crashes are also a part of this mark. Received badge is epic fail, the worst badge ever for a mod to have. Now for some add-ons. Crashing issues are going to take 1 point from the mod score because it's considered a game-breaking problem. But PC crashing problems are going to take 3 points because they are not only game-breaking, but interfere with the user's operating system and PC, and that is a serious red flag for me. Frame drops will take 1 point. The reason behind is a game from 2006 won't properly work on a 2012-2017 PC? Come on, what kind of a joke is this anyway? This is what I wanted to cover in this video, everyone. I would like to thank you for watching this update video. Don't forget to click the button from the upright corner vote to vote for the most favorable variant length video related to Battlefield 2. Funny stuff is that big YouTubers like to troll with 3 likes mark, but that for me is kinda not a troll. So let's hit 3 likes on this video for me to know that people really care about Battlefield 2 in 2017. With the death of Revive, it's really important. Thanks for coming by, see you in the game zone.